Hello, there we go. Right, just getting it all fired up here. I was going to say morning then. Good evening, good evening. Hopefully everybody's keeping well. Welcome, welcome back. Oh, God, big burp. Cube raid, that's it. Sorry, just burping up my dinner there. Hello, how are we doing this lovely Sunday evening? Hopefully everybody's keeping well. Not too much happening on Planet Joe at the moment. Hopefully people are keeping in good nick. Yeah, we're going to be chilling out with some Bomber Crew this evening. It's been a little bit of time since we played Bomber Crew, so I thought, you know what, I'm going to dust it off and have a mooch at some Bomber Crew. Hello, Elf. Good to see you, mate. And Ash and Dutch, all of the regulars. Ghost Reader, of course. 12 months. Thank you very much, mate. And also to J Frank there. What should we name it, Q? It's a fair question. Thanks for the entertainment as I try not to die on my new Peloton. What? That's it. Finding flat mates is exciting. Oh, I bet it is. You should do like what chores. There should be like a resume for flat mates. It's like what chores you're okay with doing. Can Hoover does not like dishes. You know, something like that. We'd make it infinitely helpful, like a portfolio or something, and have pictures of various plates that are squeaky clean. I don't know. That would make it easy. Hello, Toby. Good to see you, mate. Welcome, welcome. A fine evening, you English gentleman. That's the one. Hopefully you're keeping well. You're German, Toby, aren't you, my German friend? We've been assigned just trying to find out who they are. Ah, right. Lovely. Q, can you pronounce my name? I asked ZF Sheep and Dinkle, and they got it wrong, but I have a feeling you will get it right. I want to say... Daithy. Daithy? I don't know. How am I doing? Might have got it wrong. You'll have to tell me how I pronounce it if I've got it wrong there. I would say Daithy. Dahi? You reckon? Brr, that's the one. Austrian, there's a big difference. We were the ones who did nothing wrong in World War II, just like Magnus, that's it. You and Sheep said the same thing. Daithy. I would say Daithy. How would you? A die, day, day, I, day, die, day, I, thai. I know. It's getting racist. Yeah, I don't know. I would say Daithy to that, if I was to have a read. Lovely. Dare I thee, that's true. Peloton is a fancy stationary bike. Ah, so just a bike, an exercise bike. Need something in my apartment since my gym has been closed in since March. That's a good idea. Dorhi, is it? Irish for David. It's not how I would have pronounced that, but yeah, Dorhi then. Dorhi, lovely stuff. Hello, Canadian. Good to see you, matey. Welcome, welcome. Yeah, we're just going to be chilling out with some Bomber Crew this evening, so I'm going to load up the game here. It's been a little bit of a long time, but I wanted to leave it with a bit of a gap in between this Bomber Crew, or the last Bomber Crew session and this one. I wanted to leave it for a little bit of time, just so that we weren't playing the same missions over and over again. By starting instantly, to let us load up some of the crew, of which we will do some bombing. We've even got a capture window all pre-set up for this one, which is good. Matey gets Dawid wrong half the time. What do you mean? It's Dawid, isn't it? Don't be telling me it's not Dawid. Weird engine noises, that's the one. Hello, Sour Conan, good to see you, mate. Welcome, welcome. This, unless I've changed the capture window for this, this should hook in any second. It looks like I have stolen this for League at some point. That's a bit weird, isn't it? So not media source. So if I turn off that one, we need to keep that. Close that. I'm guessing that's League game. No. We want Bomber Crew. It's been a while since I played League. I didn't realise I'd stolen the capture window. There we go. Lovely. It's pronounced D-ha. Lovely. Right, how have I been this fine day? I've not been too bad, Tiberius. I've had a short day at work today, a 5-hour shift, 11 till 4. Yeah, just sort of chilled out, to be honest. Had a long wait at the train station today, 30 minutes. Space crew. We do need to have a look at that, actually. It's on my list of many things to do. Space crew, that's it. This is Beckfast's crew here, all immortalized in stone for their victory in the campaign. But today, we are loading up this new campaign here. We're going to select this one in the Keep Calm. We're going to overwrite, and we're going to rock and roll. Have you looked into... Thanks for answering it. No worries. You worked on a Sunday. My goodness, glad it wasn't for too long. That's the one. I used to do both days on the weekend, so it wasn't that much of an issue for me, to be honest. It's what I'm going to be doing is renegotiating my contract with my director. We were shuffling around some of the contracts anyway due to coronavirus. But one of the things now is I've moved out. I've got a new, I've got a girlfriend. I know, right? I basically want to have some time on the weekend with her, which I can't do if I because I do a Saturday Sunday shift. Before I was a bedroom hermit, maximum introvert. Going out on the weekend used to social interaction. It's just freak me out. But no, I fucking now. You're not becoming a full-time strimmer boy. I don't know, Toby. I definitely think I want to prioritize more on streaming. But I think too many people put the eggs in the basket of live streaming, right? I don't stream for
Oh,
long six, seven, eight,
yeah.
9 hours a day. I don't feel like that's necessarily fun. I feel like you burn out on gaming quite quickly with that. One of the things that I want to do is I want to make sure I keep my job at Specsavers to at least some degree. I only do a 4-day week at the moment. I'm doing five during the coronavirus period because of short staffing. But normally I only do a 4-day week. I think lowest I'd ever go would. I want to keep at least some work. I want to have at least some employment history. Do you know what I mean? It's just it's going to be difficult. Like when I say some vaguely, I don't know. Normally how it goes in the media is that somebody will dig up a clip from 8 years ago where you said something controversial. And they'll be like, look at it, look at it. And then that's it. Your career on Twitch is over. And so when I go back to the world of work eventually or whatever, after my channel has collapsed in on itself, I need to be able to go. And so what was your employment history between 2020 and 2028? And I was like, well, I never wore a pair of trousers except for formal gatherings, and I play computer games. And I play computer games for 8 years straight. Get out of my office. Get out. it was a I don't think it would. I don't think it would. It's a hard to swallow pill, for a what's it there, for an employer. So what I want to do is make sure that I have a job, even if it's only part time, even if it's not full crank, because streaming does take some of the pressure off that. I don't necessarily need to do full time work because of the generosity of Twitch chat. Find my PayPal below. No, so fuck yeah, it's like it's just because of the generosity of you guys, I can obviously do this not full time, but mostly full time. It's nice to balance a half and half because if either one of them kicks the tin, I have the other, rather than putting all of my eggs in one basket. So I feel that's all right. You can sign up to be a QA game tester if you're not fucked. It's true. But you've never said anything controversial, never ever, except the entire Rising Storm bullshitteries. I tell you what, if like, because I mean, Jesus, like tongue in cheek, race-based comedy from 30 years ago is getting cleared out of BBC archives today. Maybe in 10 years' time, the Rising Storm bullshitteries will be seen as really unethical and distasteful, and the media will come after me with their pitchforks and torches. It's entirely possible. Fear might happen here. Have you looked into your Discord channel recently? That was Tate Mars, yeah. You're doing the right thing, but if someday something releases Tate's Discord history, a lot of people will be fucked. Yeah, it's true. It's exactly. You've got to gotta be careful, man. Gotta be so careful. Hello, Q. Hello, chat. Burned my footage because of a random hot piece of coal hidden in the grass during a barbecue. Nice. Burned my. I said. Why did I say footage? Burned my foot. Lovely. I don't know why I said burnt my footage. Then you can pull the sub apology video. I do not have a pet creature of choice to pet, and I'm gonna have to buy some mascara so I can have the tears running down my face. Oh, it's gonna be beautiful, beautiful, darling. lovely. Anyway, we should actually play the game, shouldn't we? QX cover party. That's it. So, yes, Bomber Crew. Let's get back to the game here. Ask Soviet to borrow Lulu. That's it. Fuck that white ice. Ice leaning bullshit. No, that's it. That's it. You got Toby. It's controversial. It's controversial, Toby. You must keep the politics away. His pet is Jaina. That's it. At home with Corona, watching Quebec myself. Suddenly have a lot of time on my hands. Oh, you've been let go, Sky. I'm really sorry. Like, the state of the... We will get to the game, I promise, Cube Waffle. Yeah, like, it's... Like, the state of, like, the jobs market is not going to be fully felt until after we come out. At least here in the UK, it's not going to be felt until after furlough ends. At least with furlough hanging on in there until October, some companies that would have had to lay people off for it may be trying to hang on as long as possible. I will keep hydrate at the very least. You know, people, they're trying to hang on as long as possible so that maybe the sort of profits and net earnings of the business might sort of bounce back enough to maybe save some of those employees. But the furlough scheme is just kicking the can further down the road, unfortunately. It's like, if it's only going to last so long. It was never an infinite thing, and it can't really be extended past October, sadly. It's just not financially viable. And so once the, you know, fucking furlough ends in October, then we'll get a full idea in the UK here just how bad the job market is going to be. So I think quitting and going to full-time streaming is probably a bad idea, because it's charity driven. It's driven by you guys subbing and donating, whatever else. That if that was my primary source of income, going into a global financial recession is probably a bad idea to ask for charity as your primary form of income. And then the second thing as well is that I think it would be bananas to say, you know what, I know there's a global financial recession and everybody's really hard off. I want to quit my job, you know, and I'm going to go it alone. You know, it's probably a bad idea. We need a bear in latex gear called Cube Pet. Keep your weird Austrian sex dungeon fetishes away from my chat, Toby. Jesus Christ. I'm from Germany and was on 50% furlough, half work for 80% of my wages. Was kind of nice, yeah. What are you up to, Q? Hope you're doing well. I'm not doing bad, Karis. I'm glad my work has finally gotten busier since Corona started. Less stress. Ah, right. Okay. This is a Christian chat. Anyway, finally, some gameplay. Let's rock and roll, shall we? Is the game really quiet for you guys? I feel like it is. I know that there's, like, not much... Is that, like, too quiet? I suppose that's only background music. What a sorry bunch of bastards. Beautiful mustache on the end there. Right, well, this is going to be the first part of our journey here. Thank you very much there to Dwayne Mulroy. Long live Quebec. Cube salute, sir. Thank you very much. It's, like, 4 out of 10 volume. It's only meant to be background stuff. We'll turn it up if we need to. So, what we see in front of us here are 9 individuals making up the USAAF here, the United States Army Air Force, not to be confused with the United States Air Forces, like the Army branch of the Air Force. And today we need to choose 9 sorry suckers from chat here in order to, operate our B-17 Flying Fortress, which will be nice. Let's rock and roll. Let's see who we're going to choose here. So, in the first position, we've got Marshal Ramos here. This is similar to FTR. We're just going to give characters away to people in chat here. Let's go with Alex the Thief here as our pilot. Just his name caught my eye there. We'll say Alex for short, because I like calling like little buzz names. So Alex the Thief, that's going to be your character, sir. Our chief mechanic here. Look at this sauerkraut. And the only sauerkraut, and which is going to really annoy him because he's Austrian, we're going to map as Toby here. That is a tabby, as I call him. No, Toby. The sourest kraut. That's the one. Let's get him in. And we've got Nigerian Bernie Sanders. Let's get him over here. Let's have a look. Who is going to be our navigator? Let's go with Mr. Jive Crayfish, one of the moderators. Again, I'm just picking out people quickly as their names. Jive Cray. Jive's Cray, bro. Let's go with Jive Crayfish. Let's get him in there. Okay, and now we need a radio operator. Slightly happier kraut. Let's have a look here. Let's go with Sour Conan. We'll call you Conan for short. Let's get you in here. Conan, welcome on board. You are going to be our radio operator. And then a plethora of gunners. All the bells and whistles and stuff here. It's bloody... What's it that hosts Family Fortunes? I can't remember his name. Here he is. Let's get him on board. Right. Let's have a look here. Judge Dredd Deman, yeah, let's get you on there. Let's call you, let's go Deman. He is nothing short than Deman. Let's get you on there. Welcome, welcome. Mr. Hicks here, again. That is the world's smallest. That is a puckered ass that is a mouth. Jesus Christ. Let's go with, Nyx there. Nyx the Elf. Let's go NYX. Welcome on board, sir. You're going to be one of our gunners here. Next gunner along is going to be, oh, those are big eyes. Holy shit. Oh, that's terrible. Looks like Tony Blair. Looks like Tony Blair. Jesus Christ. Let's see. Let's go with Daman as well. Daman, or Daman Jab even. Let's get you on board, sir. So Daman Nick's. Oh no, we've already got another Daman. Oh, that's going to be confusing. We've already got another Daman. Daman 2. There we go. Right. Okay. That's the other Daman. Two Damans. That's going to be confusing. And then let's go with Duo Man. Right. Let's see. New campaign. That's the one. And just for saying that, just for saying PogChamp, Kylo, welcome on board our plane there. Lovely. And last but not least, then, our bomb drop operator with his glorious mustache. There's only one person in chat with a mustache as glorious as that. And it's Miss Jen. No, sorry. Let's go with let's go with the Briest. Welcome on board. Lovely. Brilliant. Glorious British mustache. That's the one. Right, okay. So that is our crew members on board here. We've got Alex the Thief up on the front. We've got Toby, our sauerkraut. Jive Crayfish, the navigator. Conan, the fucking radio operator. We've got Daman 1 on the guns. We've got Daman 2 on the guns. We've got Nyx, we've got Kylo, and we've got the Briest as well. Bish, I've been called a Basil Bish, that's it. Right, let us rock and roll then. So that is our crew member on board there. We're going to be going through and we're going to be just getting rid of all of these upgrade dots, all of the things that they keep telling us that we've got. I can't, like, use the arrow keys. Can I use the arrow keys? No, I can't use the arrow keys. This is, like, a game that's very mobile-friendly. So what are arrow keys, exactly? Thank you very much there, too. Is it Skitto? Sitto? Thank you very much there for the 16 months. Good even, Monsieur Quebec. That is me. Small oxygen bottles of various types. We're not too bothered about that. Combined survival vests. We're probably going to be spending our money on the plane to start with. As a... bruh. We're pretty poor at the moment. We got headphones and stuff, which is absolutely crack-a-lackin'. A couple of spare radio sets, which is lovely. And then the headgear as well. Okay, not bad. Everything to play for, everything to choose. Right then, let us introduce ourselves to the aircraft itself then. Auto-generated name is Flak Magnet. Not a bad name for an aircraft, I must be honest. We're going to jump into the livery here and we're going to set up the engine art and everything like that. Although I'm not entirely sure. Do I have custom roundels for this thing yet? Well, not the right roundels, but better than nothing. Tail art roundel 1. In fact, we have geometric IDA for the tail roundel there. That will do for the moment in our B-17. Right then, let's have all of the engine arts okay. Can I equip better guns at the moment? I have no better guns equipped at the moment, so there's not much I can do about that. I could get some of these real cheapo guns up the front, and I think I will for our gunner here. So let's get you and you there with a couple of our forward-facing guns. Right then, let us name our aircraft, the Flak Magnet. What do we want to call? Do we want to go with the Flak Magnet? Do we want to keep that? What's it? Someone came up with the awesome name for a bomber, the Memphis Bear, which was really good. But I don't know whether we want to go with that one. The Flying Fartress, that is true to form for me, unfortunately. Flying Gen, that's it. Killmonger is pretty good. Bear Naked Lady, that's the one. Flak Magnet is awesome. It's a pretty good name for a bomber, isn't it? We could keep in the Flak Magnet. What do we think, then? What do we think? Flak Magnet, the Fisherman's Awaiting, that's it. Plain McClane face. Call it Harris. Jesus. Keep Flak Magnet. Flak Magnet. The gritsy bitsy teeny weeny bombing. Yeah, that's the one. That's the one. Barely airborne. I like that one. Gary. Gary the bomber. Jesus Christ. The bomb bearer. I was going to say, you said the bear bomber. That's a bit later in history. Flak Bear Henry. What are these names? Jim? Mr. Bombastic. I think the song predates or outdates this war by quite a bit. Oh god, not your mother-in-law, that's the one. Lady Bear, that's the one. The boombox, not bad for a bomber there. Ein Freund, meaning a friend. Meaning no German will shoot at us. It's sort of a message of subterfuge there, I like that. That's good. Getting in their head, Toby. This American-German agent. The bearer of bombs, isn't too bad. Tom Bombadil, that's pretty good. There's a reference, fucking hell, Tom Bombadil. Lord of the Rings lore there, Jesus. The Elf Shelf. You're not on this plane. We could have it honorary of Elf, though. The Blockbuster, not a bomber. Not a bomber. So that's it. Winged Chonkus. Winged Chonkus, that's the one. I am the mascot. That's the one. Yeah, fucking bear air, that's it. Completely invisible. I don't know. I, you know what? We'll go with flak. What would you keep flak magnet, to be honest? Chunk solidarity. I'm sorry, Elf. You're never going to shake that, unfortunately. Jane will never forget. Right. Bear necessity. Another good one. Chunk solidarity, man. That's it. Right. Let's go with... Yeah, we'll just leave it as flak magnet for now. I'll tell you what, that does a job, doesn't it? I am Twig. Won't I... Twig. We could just call this plane Twig. The big Twig. You're asking for us to get shot down. Not a flak magnet. If it works for not a truck, it could work for us. Civilian casualties, that's it. Okay, we'll keep it as flak magnet for now. Flak magnet will do, or I should call it not a flak magnet. Right, let us go back to crew gear then. We've got 2.2k to try and get our guys some better equipment here. We've got the olive flight suits, which I'm going to give for everyone there, because I just like them. And then let's have a look at all of our different crew members here with regards to bits of kit here. So we got the pilot's cap Mark II here for our pilot. So let's put that on for Mr. Alex here. Toby we need moving quite quickly. So we're going to get him in with the service cap here. Look at our sauerkraut friend, lovely. He's going to be running around at half the speed of sound. Our navigator here. Let's see, do we want to get you in flying leathers? I think we probably do. Let's get you equipped with them for us. Mr. Conan, you are our radio operator, so let's get you in with a set of headphones there. Keeping on the radio, making sure that there's no one else nearby. The man here, you're probably going to want... Yeah, we'll get you some aviators. Ninx, we'll get you just normal. There we go. The man 2, we'll get you... Oh, Tony Blair. Yeah, we'll get you fucking... It is, honestly, it's Tony Blair. That's terrifying. Kylo here, let's get you with some aviators on board. And Bryest, I think. Nah, you can't hide a mustache like that. It's terrifying. The eyes. Those eyes have seen some shit. Let's get you that then. Right, in terms of gloves and gear then, let's have a look at boots and things. We've got leather boots and toughened leather boots for all parties. That's going to cost us a shitload of money. I think we'll just go with default leather boots for everyone. And then in terms of gloves, we could go with woolen or we could go with leather. Again, I think I'm going to go with leather just to give everybody just some gloves. It's better than nothing. Right then, so that is our crew for the moment. Welcome on board all and everyone there. We've got Alex, Toby, Jive, Conan, Deman, Ninx, Deman 2, Kylo and Bryest there, which is lovely. I've got to come up with a better name for Deman 2. I should... like try and separate the names, shouldn't I? How would I separate the names? I can't even remember which Deman is which now. I think Jeb Deman? I don't know, Jarman, not Deman. That's it. Wookiebeck failed this mission. It's almost true. Deman and Demam. That's it. We call you Judge. You're the first one, aren't you? The Judge Dread Deman. Let's call you Judge. There we go. That makes life easier. There it is. Lovely. We'll call you Judge. So we got Judge and Deman. We'll call that you are now. You've been upgraded to Deman 1. Tony Blair. Tony Deman. It's got to be. It's fucking God. It's Tony Blair. Get it away. Right. Okay. Good old Billy Judge. That's it. Right. So let us. I think we're going to be going up for our full mission here. Ooh, £5 from Deman.
Which Starman am I, or do I have a split personality?
Split personality. Thank you, Edna. Edna's having a stronk. Which Darman are you? Well, I don't know which Darman, but you're now... You are Darman. You are Darman. Which we shall try to call you for the rest of the name. Rest of the game, sorry. Darman. Lovely. Right, let us go to the briefing then, so that's all sorted. We do actually, before we head to the briefing, we need to choose a flight squadron for our aircraft. What's going to be our flight squadron? What should we have as our flight squadron? Waste text, white flight, waste text. Change bomb drop livery or livery here. What should we have with this? Let's call it... We could have our honorary flight squadron ELF here. Doesn't have a number in. Flak, Brexit, We could have Flight Squadron Elf. What do we think about that? Is chat happy with that? What do we reckon? Killmonger. Yes. I think we're going to go Honorary Elf here. See, whenever you refer to it's like a secret handshake. You just sort of grab a bingo wing. Strong solidarity. That's it. You like shake the bit. Anyway, moving on. Right, so yeah, we go Flight Squadron ELF. Lovely. It's going to be absolutely brilliant. Because Nyx is here too. Lovely, there you go. Nyx the Elf. We've got many Elves on board then. Santa's fucking going to be short of staff this year. Right, let's go. So, Flight Squadron ELF. The Flak Magnet. Taking off and getting ready to dish out some pain, it looks like. Lovely stuff. Yeah, we're going to keep it as the Flak Magnet. I didn't see any names that really leapt out at me, unfortunately. Flammenwerfer. So the Germans see us coming, they will scream, Hans, the Flammenwerfer is coming. Is that right? Lovely. Again, weird Austrian-German dungeon fantasy here. Yeah, our sauerkraut. Coronavirus, I just called it.
Coronavirus.
Lovely. Have I read Catch 22? Yes. Dunno. Well, you can't read a movie.
Obviously.
Unless it's in teletext. You've heard of teletext. Surely your dad at some point has watched teletext. There's a blast from the past, teletext.
No?
No? You don't know what teletext is?
Never.
Is it like an English thing? Surely, is teletext just an English thing? Is it just something my dad... Yeah, that's going back a bit, yeah. I'm surprised you don't remember it.
Fuck off. Bitch.
So, bish. Anyway, yeah, Flight Squadron ELF. Right. Nope, same over here, that's it. Never heard of it in Austria. Ah, right. We had it in Belgium as well. Right then. Let us jump on into the game then. So, there is our aircraft. Good stuff. As if you don't know Hans Flammenwerfer means. I mean flamethrower, that's it. I don't know. Is Dutch as well? True statement. Right, so let us rock and roll with our first mission here. So the bomber command here has got Operation Torture has been a fine success. Now we've got to consolidate our foothold in North Africa. The enemy holding out at Tunis is stockpiling ammunition. Send it up in smoke. Let us begin our mission here. Here we go, our first mission of our new campaign. Hopefully we'll make a decent show with this. Level 1, look at it, fresh as the virgin snow, look at it. Right then, so in terms of people in the various positions here, Judge, I feel like you should be judged from behind. I think that's his sexual deviance in the rear gunner there. We've got Deman and Kylo Ren, Kylo Ren's Deman, on the waist guns there. We've got Nyx, who's going to be responsible for our roof gun operation for the moment, so we're going to get him moving forward as our primary gun operator. And yeah, we're going to roll from there. So, look at that glorious mustache. Look at that. What a majestic way to die. Apparently we're moving in Jive's head. I'm not entirely sure. Anyway, let us lock in our pilot here and take off from the runway. So the roof gun is going to be primarily where a lot of the shooting gets done, as it covers the entire sort of top sweep of the aircraft, which means nothing's really going to be able to approach from our, you know, above vector. On the top of the aircraft there without getting in the fire of this gun. The various waist guns and stuff have various arcs of fire, and the ball gun underneath is responsible for shooting at anything that may slot underneath us. One of the things that slots underneath us quite a lot is heavy fighters in particular that like to shoot up into the bottom of the plane from below, and that is really what the ball gun is there to address. Really becomes more useful at high and medium altitudes, but for the moment with our scrub-ass crew and the scrub-ass overlord that is piloting it, low altitude is going to be what we're sticking to today. We've got at least one bandit coming in on the left-hand side there. Bryce, if you want to man the left-hand gun, Deman, Nyx, and Bryce there. Going to be all responsible for shooting this guy down. A little bit of fire discipline coming in there, chaps. You're doing a good job. Excellent stuff. Nyx gets the kill there. I wasn't able to see the end of the previous campaign. How did it go? We burned in the fires of hell. We basically got shot down and bankrupted to the point where, like, the point at the campaign we were at, it kind of meant that coming back was impossible because we couldn't get enough money to get a decent plane. Another fighter, two fighters, closing in from 12 o'clock high, get them tagged. Nix, this is very much your department. Try and come round onto the right gun there, Bryce. You might have a bit more luck. There we go, Bryce is on target. We've got Kylo spraying in as well. Some reloads going in there. Bryce gets himself a kill. Excellent stuff. Both of those planes are down, which is excellent. Pilot, bring us to our 10 o'clock left there. What actually is my job? I'm just standing there not doing anything. Your job is this. You repair things. That is your qualification, sir. Whereas everybody else is going to be getting heavily clad in body armor, I'm basically giving you a pair of dinosaur underpants and some slippers, and that is it. That's all you're getting, because I need you to be very quick up and down the aircraft. Ooh, three guys diving in from very high left. Nix, that's going to be mostly on you, I reckon. Bryce, come over to the left-hand gun, see if you can do anything. Just get some fucking bullets up on target. Swing us around a little bit. Excellent shooting, chaps. Good bit of fire discipline. Go on then, Demand. A little bit of damage on the rear part of the plane there. Nothing too serious. Toby, back to your seat then. Yeah, Toby. You use your hands. Yeah, I like it. Beautiful. Decent spray from the judge there, although Jive actually ended up getting the kill there. Which, did Jive get the kill? Surely not, unless he killed him with his mind. I think it was Judge. Right, give Toby some Crocs or something. God damn. Well, we can get him some plimsolls, believe it or not. Actual, genuine plimsolls, which is awesome. I can't wait to give him that. Right then, objective is coming up. We're going to open the bomb bay doors, ready two sets of armor-piercing bombs for the factories. Here we go. Let's see how we do. You think with how successful your mission rate is, they give you at least a couple of extra hands to operate the guns, I know, right? Excellent. Down we go. Bombs, bombs, bombs away. Factory has been engaged and destroyed. No optional reconnaissance. Oh, there it is. We're getting reports. Speak and you shall receive. We're getting reports of an enemy shipping. Go and photograph any activity. That we shall endeavour to do. Nobody else nearby. A little bit of AAA fire into the fuselage there. Nothing the big beast can't handle. You'll do A-OK. Let's see what we're photographing. Is it? It looks like an aircraft or a massive battleship. Oh, that's a lot of flak fire coming in. Hopefully the plane will be able to take this. Here, I forgot my glasses at the airbase. That's it. It's the Graf Zeppelin. It's not supposed to be operational yet. Oh, it is an aircraft carrier. Get a photo and return to base. Very well. We've got to fly in, taking the little bit of 20mm fire that we're getting slapped in the bottom with. Nothing we can't handle, though. And ready to take a photo and snap the photograph. Lovely. Well, they've got some fighters taking off. Let's get that guy tanked quickly. And let's try and pull back and away there. Kylo, if I can, come down to the ball gun here. Where we're going to need you. We've got another plane taking off to our rear. Judge, that is very much in your sector of fire. Swing us to our 9 o'clock, please. Pilot, holding low altitude. Let's see how we do. Keep the fire going in, chaps. You're doing well. Bryce, on the left-hand gun for me, please. Get a bit of fire discipline downrange. Excellent stuff. Another fighter there. Get him tagged. Another biplane on the back left. Demand, very much your department, sir. Yeah, they are really... These aviators clearly aren't prescription. There we go. And good shooting from Judge on the rear there as well. A little bit of damage here and there for the for the gunners and stuff in particular. A little bit beat up. But not bad experience for the entry mission. God, my audio encoding just died, did it? You can handle being slapped on the bottom? Absolutely. Jane can confirm. Spontaneous bomb attack. There we go. There's our targets. Managed to grab them quickly. 1, 2, 3 targets left. High. Feel like a rally driver. 7 into crest. Over ridge, keep right. There we go. Another guy coming in from the right-hand side there. Where is he? There they are. I've got him. 3 bandits right. Let's get Bryce to switch side here onto the right-hand forward gun. Oh, and more bandits. God, they're absolutely swarming us. It's like ants. No notifications again. Classic Twitch. Lovely stuff round on the right here. Nice spray and pray in there. That's the stuff. Excellent damage in on the side there. Oh my god, Kylo, get over here. Holy shitting god. Get yourself healed up, boy. God, he got massacred. Jeez, that was very nearly the end of him. Nick's got another good shot off there. Keep the fire discipline up. We've got more fighters buzzing around us. Centre fuselage is struggling here. There we go. There they are. 1, 2, 3 closing in from our 1 o'clock high. Get close to the airbase again. Demand on the right. Keep it moving, chaps. Hope that airframe holds out for just a little bit longer. Go on, Judge. You'll be all right. Have they pulled off, have they? It looks like, yeah, they're pulling off because we're getting close to the airbase. Wow. I mean, for a starting mission, that was pretty brutal. There it is. I'm surprised. I wonder if an invisible hand, like, sort of denied him death, or whether he actually just survived on 1 HP there. Lovely. Not looking too fresh, it's very true. We're going to pull into the runway here, touchdown, and try and get some R&R for the guys, and try and put what's left of Kylo's body parts back together. We need a needle and thread. Right, let us lower the landing gear here. It's going to increase our aerodynamic drag. But yes, we're unfortunately got no choice here. We've got to touch down and land. The airframe's not looking too fresh. There's a lot of fighters, to be fair. A lot of fighters. Jumped in front of the bullets for the lads. That's it, Kylo. Doing a good job. What happened to the other aircraft, High Bacon? The other aircraft, sorry. The previous campaign I've left behind. We're doing a fresh one, just because we basically got bankrupted in the last one. So I count that as a loss, basically. And so yeah, we're here we are, fresh. Lovely jubbly. Also, I'd like to say, 40 minutes in and 498 people. Hello to the lurkers hiding in the bottom there. Good to see you all. Welcome, welcome. Right then, so the ammo dump at Tunis has been destroyed. Return to base bonus is $800, and also a no slow time bonus of 80, which is very nice. I'm not doing too bad. I'm not doing too bad there, Mr. Pascal. Thanks for asking, mate. Ahoy, lad. That's it. Good to see you all. Big lurk. That's it. Right then, so with that guy engaged and destroyed, we should get a little bit of XP for our efforts here, so we're just going to speed through that. Level 3 and a bit. Lovely. Focus fire on most of our gunners here. Bryce, I'm not sure. I think he's locked his second level now, which is excellent. We've got radio for recon, which is going to be perfect for spotting areas of reconnaissance but that require our attention, which is fantastic. I am going to have a quick cube hydrate here. Didn't get experience nor cash from the recon photo again. If they're built into the mission, then that you don't get them. But if you spontaneously find them as a side objective, then yeah, then you get them. Spicky is not lurking. Thank you for declaring. Right then, so let us have a mooch here then. So moving on from that, we've unlocked yellow text, about a million other things. Oh, it's going to like rediscover. This is all the stuff that we had before, but it's like saying that we've officially unlocked them. Which is a big pain in the bum. Is it going to make me fucking find them all again? Don't do it. No, okay, it's just flight suits. We've unlocked thermal flight suit Mark II. It's a little bit expensive. I'm not going to be putting that on straight away. All of these different presets and stuff. What have we got? Gloves. Fingerless gloves. Not really too keen on that yet. Except maybe on Toby, who is going to be a very speedy boy. Pilot's cap Mark III there. Absolutely gorgeous. Your boy's got to have that, hasn't he? But he looks fantastic. Right, Toby here. Let's have a look at you. What can you get? Can we get you plimsolls yet? Not quite. We don't have the research. But the fingerless gloves, for reasons unknown to medical science, make you 10% faster. Because everybody knows that woolen gloves are stitched with what can only be described as solid steel in the fingertips. So if you take that off, suddenly you're fucking speedboat. So we're going to get you $100 for fingerless gloves. Jesus, that is a very sauerkraut. Right, so yeah, we're going to leave him with there because that's going to make him 105 speed, which is very, very nice. In terms of training, as ever, we're going to get Mr. Bryce trained as a gunner, as he is operating the forward guns pretty much on his own. And then we could even get Toby trained as a gunner eventually, although I might get him trained as a... Probably as a... No. Medic is always nice, but having him trained as a pilot as a secondary is probably the more wise decision of the two. But we shall see, closer to the time. Right then, let us go briefing and let us just do another mission, just like that. In fact, are we going to do the bomb drop liveries? Oh, go on. I suppose we should, shouldn't we? Custom one, customize. It doesn't look like we got very far with our other plane, so it's not much to rub out. Let's go like so. Here we go. Our first mission complete. That's going to creep out from beyond the propeller there, which is great. Right then, let us go back to the briefing then with our first mission in tow, and let us move out into the big wide world. Three different missions available: coastal patrol, allied transport shipping, and enemy airfield at Monserrat.
Let us do
this mission first, as it gets us enemy damage down for the next two turns. See you later, Brook. How was my weekend, Ricey? Pretty damn good. And thank you very much to Be Our Commander for gifting a tier one sub to Mara Tales there. Very, very kind. Let us take off from the runway here, locking in the pilot into his seat so he doesn't go for a wander around the aircraft, thanks to a misclick from me. We're going to be staying down at low altitude for this mission, and we're going to get Nyx, as ever, up to the roof gun, ready for those high altitude attacks. We're going to get our pilot, Alex, here to raise the landing gear, and he's just going to bank us to our 1 o'clock from the runway, taking us to the objective here, which is lovely. My weekend's been all right. Obviously been at work. I do both days on the weekend at the moment. But yeah, it's been a little bit interesting. Glad that I've got tomorrow off at least, because nobody likes Mondays. I'm going to be enjoying my time off a little bit. I've been trying to get through Lord of the Rings, the director's cut. I'm now on the Two Towers officially, and it's good. I've got about an hour, 2 hours into that film. I've still got like another two left, which is great. The squid says my great-grandpa was a bombardier, different thing, on a B-24. Wow, a Liberator, lovely. Good stuff. Two Towers, the second Lord of the Rings film. Good stuff. New course plotted, pilot bring us 10 o'clock left, low. Excellent stuff. Magnifique. Let's see if we can bump into anyone here on radar in particular. That's one of the things that we're going to need to get upgraded. Radar, as you can see here, taking a very long time to sweep around the aircraft. Our initial warning of enemy aircraft is very, very delayed. And it doesn't give us... Like, as we get later into the game, it will give us more and more shit. There they are. Coming in from 2 o'clock to 3 o'clock high. Let's get Bryce on the right here. Kylo, that's very much your department as well. Let's get Nyx here to focus fire there with his dual guns. We should have a little bit of decent fire discipline coming out here. Absolutely laser precision. Coming in here to what looks to be a medium altitude flak field. We're staying down low, so we're going to be travelling through it. Flak isn't detonating until a little bit higher up, so by staying down low here, we're in a pretty good spot. Let's get Mr. Cohen in here to radio for recon, see what's around. And then we'll go from there. Nearby hazard spotted on the map. Oh god, we've got three bandits coming in left. We've got a BF-109 and a couple of Focke-Wulfs, it looks like, coming in from the left-hand side there. Let's get Bryce on the left. We've got more fighters coming in directly ahead. We've got biplanes coming in 12 o'clock. Mr. Bryce, that is going to be very much your and Nix's department here. We've got our target coming in on the right-hand side here. Let us swing round for that now. Tag our other plane coming in there. Let's quickly move Kylo to the ball gun at the bottom, Bryce to the forward gun compartment, and let's hope that Kylo's got what he needs to land this kill. Open bomb bay doors, ready to tag another fighter closing in. BF-109 coming up from the runway here. Bombs are ready to release. Get ready to strafe those hangars and send it. Close the bomb bay doors. Bring us round for this optional reconnaissance on what looks to be a plane or something hiding back there. Not sure, there is another plane in the air. Let's get him tagged. We've got a heavy fighter coming in on our left there. Demand, that's very much your vector of fire there. Looks like a ground objective, which is great. Right. Excellent stuff. Keep the fire going there, chaps. Bryce cannot assist in this. Coming into a low altitude flak field. Not very much we can do at the moment. Snag the photo. And let us swing back home to safety here. Swing us back out over. We've got more fighters coming in high. We've got a very heavy fighter coming in this early. Jesus. Let's get ready for some action then. Nyx, are you ready with focus fire again? Yes, you are. You're going to be reloading. Bryce on the left gun for me, please. Judge, focus fire on the rear. Demand, focus fire on the left as they come round. Lots of focus fire there. Judge, if you can, keep doing that good work for me with the rear gun. You're going to start working us. Good shooting with the dual guns. Excellent shooting, Judge. Got another guy closing in on our rear there. Excellent shooting again with the burnout. All enemies engaged and destroyed. Radio for recon's going to be coming back up very, very shortly. We can just quickly tag that and see how we're doing with regards to assets nearby. Closing the doors. We did close the doors. Lovely. Radio for recon. Bringing us round to our 10 o'clock here. Please, pilot, keep us below the flak field. More enemy fighters on radar closing in from 3 o'clock right. Low altitude. Heavy, heavy fighters coming in from that side. Mr. Demand, if you can come over on this side. Bryst as well. Demand, focus fire for me, please. Nix, can't focus fire, but if you can later, that would be most appreciated. Judge, focus fire if you can. Nope, your focus fire is on cooldown currently. Let's see how we do. They're switching round over to this side. Kylo, come in on the left gun for me here, please. Oh no, he's slotting in underneath here. Kylo, get back down to the ball gun if you can. There it is. Good shooting, good shooting. Little bit of extra aircraft coming in from somewhere high. Didn't quite catch them on radar. No, no idea where they were. Oh, there he is. He's untagged. Coming in underneath. There we go. Get the ball gunner on him. Oh, Jesus. He didn't last long. Very nice. Excellent stuff. Have I tried Space Crew? Not yet, Sleepy Kid. It's on the list of things I need to do. Lovely stuff, Bryst. What I could probably do is get you on the front left, and Toby, we might as well get him on the right gun, even though he's not gunner qualified. It's just better to have that gun working. It's not, you know, ideal, but at least it's shooting bullets, which is what we want. Lovely. Tagging helped. It certainly did. Right then, returning to the airfield, no critical damage apart from a couple of holes in the wings, but who doesn't expect a few of those if you're flying over an enemy airbase? Not bad at all. Cube Hydrate for our sins here. 303 OP, that's it. Especially the Mark 1s. Enemy fighters again. Let's hold off on that Cube Hydrate. Bandits coming in from the 2 o'clock right mark. Tag, tag, and tag. All enemies tagged. Demand and Toby are both situated on the right-hand gun along with Nix. Ready to give these guys a good broadside, although it looks like they are peeling off as we're closing in on the runway. Pre-aim, thank you very much for the tier 2 for 2 months, sir. Very, very kind. Excellent stuff. At least Kylo is a bit better off this time, it's true. He's less perforated. There's the runway. Get that locked in as a target. And let us go down to land. Absolutely brilliant. Right, quick swig. Lovely jubbly. Less Swiss cheese, that's it. Bulletproof now. Cannot be, can't get shot if there's no body parts left to get shot. You know? I'm fully perforated. There's nothing for the bullet to hit. Big thunk. Last time we used him to drain our pasta, that's the one. You're thinking of the Italian Air Force there, mate. You back the wise, apparently. Medical professional. Yeah. Oh, God, good stuff. Kylo building up a resistance to bullets. That's it. It's like a vaccine. Fucking American Air Force vaccine to bullets. Bullet resistance vaccine. They put the band on, you know, flick the elbow, you know, trying to get a vein to come up, and then they shoot you in the elbow, and that's it. Out of my fucking room. Lovely. Lead poisoning therapy, that's it. More like Quebec the Wide. Big kick. Immense sadness. No, it's all right. Okay, so what we got is $1,200 from the airfield raid. We've also got a return to base bonus of 800, no slow time bonus of 80, and some optional reconnaissance, which has paid nicely. Pay to play, apparently. It's all rigged. Right. Superb stuff. Level 4.5 for most, except for Bryst here, who's splitting his levels over 2, which is excellent. Our pilot has learnt corkscrew. Mr. Alex, thank you very much, sir. And we've also got a custom heading marker, which allows us to steer around enemy flak fields and so forth, which is great. Okay. Will Clan says, I don't need a bullet vaccine. I built a resistance by starting with BPs and going up. That's it. You can now take a full-blown 76mm tank round to the leg and just walk it off. It's like a sprained ankle to him. Right then. That is not bad at all. Various different upgrades and roundels and all kinds of shenanigans that have been unlocked. I believe roundel 2 is the actual roundel that is on the B-17. Grab that. I'm sure they used various, but I'm pretty sure that roundel 2 is the one here. So what I'm going to do, while I remember, doesn't happen often, we're going to put the second bomb drop livery in position, which is ace, and then the... That's how we are. Big yawn. What was I thinking? Yeah, the roundels. That was the one. So Wingard Roundel 2. That's the one. and the waste roundel, which is great. Geometric IDs we're going to keep as A, as it's our first aircraft survival. Inflatable Digby, Mark 1, which is nice. We've got two equipment racks, which is awesome. An electrical system Mark 2, which would actually be nice, but we're not having too many problems with that. Hello, Cowface. Good to see you, mate. Try not to yawn.
I have resisted.
Very nice then. And we've also got some Mark 2 50 cals ready for mounting here. Let's have a look then. I probably want to prioritize doing the ball gun and maybe the roof gun as well, if we can. It's probably our best course of action. Right. How do you feel about UK schools starting back? I try not to get political. I'm not political. I am a very political man. But I try to keep Joe and Quebec separate in the political world, not least because you don't want to alienate its viewers with opposing political beliefs. And this isn't the green light to go, that's it, right? Screw those Mormons, you know. Like this isn't that time. But yeah, it's like, how do I feel about people going back to school? I think it's all right. In and of its own thing. I mean, the problem is that like you just will not be able to get children to adhere to any kind of sensible social distancing measures, but every child also has the right to education. So it's kind of a double-edged sword, really. Flat earthers, love them. Requesting 20mm rail guns, sir. I don't think we're going to have... I don't think we're fresh out of those. I'm offended by your dad jokes, that's it. Bunch of weirdos. You're saying eat the rich. Only with Tangentelli. It's like it's one of those, like, children just aren't going to adhere to social distancing measures, which means it's inevitably going to spread in schools. One of the things that I was really confused about is that, like, I don't know how it is, like, I imagine most schools are like this, right? But at least here in the city, here in Birmingham, there aren't, like, enough spaces in schools. I remember very vividly from my school days, and I don't know whether it's gotten better or worse, but classrooms were already full to capacity. Right? And obviously people need to keep 1 to 2 meters away from each other. And so how are you going to take a class of 30 that's full of desks, you know, like where everybody's got 2 men to a table? Do you know what I mean? And how are you going to introduce social distancing to that environment? Because it's not like you can make the tables further apart. I mean, they're like, these classrooms are as big as they are. You know what I mean? Like, how are they going to do it? Like, I don't know. Like, I don't think there's any really sensible... Like, people are going to have to sit next to each other at tables, which means the coronavirus is going to spread in that form, or in that regard. Plexiglass glass boxes. I don't know. Like, you can't enforce children wearing masks. You can't enforce anyone wearing masks, to be honest, which was a whole different ball game. Don't go political. People will make a health issue a political one. It's true. You know, you can't enforce the wearing of face masks at schools and stuff like that. You can get your teacher nagging you, but it's not like she can give you a detention if you don't wear a face mask. Classrooms were already fit to burst, so I don't know how on earth, like, schools are going to be able to correctly enforce social distancing in the classroom, because that's where a lot of people are. Mr. Chinny, thank you very much, sir, with the 206. Welcome. Welcome, Chinny. We're getting not very political. Are anti-maskers a political? I would say that's a political stance. Because you don't want the government to have the rule over you that you have to wear a mask. I would say that I would say anti-masking is a political ideology. Sort of in and of its own right. You could send them home in the US, yeah, I suppose. But yeah, here in the UK, I don't know how it's going to be enforced. It's really frustrating because, at least in my shop, we're not allowed to refuse customers that don't wear face masks. Because here in the UK, and I don't know how it is in the rest of the world, like, if you tell a Karen to just go away, you know, she could say, like, and this is a genuine fear of retailers, they could open up a disability. So let's say, for example, I'm going to put a hypothetical scenario in front of you. There's a woman in front of you, and she doesn't have a mask, and you say, can you put a mask on? And she says no. It's like, look, unfortunately, I'm going to have to refuse your service because you're refusing to put a mask on, even though it's, you know, in the interests of everyone else, you know. There was a really good quote that I saw on Reddit earlier, and I know quoting from Reddit isn't exactly pulling from the Bible, but it was, you know, the wisdom was there. And it was like, it was something along the lines of, you know, even if it turns out that masks were useless, if it was all a hoax, if it was, you know, if I am one of the sheeple that is wearing them and I'm completely submissive to any kind of government policy that appears before me, I will lose absolutely no sleep at night knowing that I loved thy neighbour as I loved myself. You know what I mean? Like, or as I love myself, you know, that I, even if it didn't do anything in the end after we look back on it, you know, at least, you know, I was thoughtful enough to try and protect other people. You know what I mean? But that's it. Don't we wear them by law in the UK now? Technically speaking, yes, Dark Rush. But the only people that can enforce it are police officers. And there aren't enough police officers, unfortunately. You cannot be forced to wear a mask in an enclosed public space by anyone other than a police officer. If you go to a shop, this isn't like a fucking life hack guide, but if you went to a shop without a mask and say, I'm sorry, I don't have a mask, the only person that would be able to refuse you entry would be the proprietor of the store, like the director or the store manager, and in that case, and what all shops are terrified of, and so therefore nobody does it, is you opening a discriminatory case against them. Right, so let's say if you've got asthma, and for that reason you can't wear a mask, but you don't carry around 18 doctor's letters under each hand explaining that you have asthma and you can't wear these masks. If a store refuses you, you can open up a disability discrimination charge against the practice. And that is something that a fucking lawyer will take you to the absolute brown town cleaner with a wire brush. Like, it just, there's nothing you can do. And so, literally, rather than risk the liability of one of these discrimination lawsuits because it's bad press for the overall business, they just say, yeah, come on in. Yeah, civil lawsuit, exactly. So that's where it is, unfortunately. So the only person that can enforce you wearing a face mask is a police officer, because they are protected in some regards under law. They are obviously enforcing the law that it is, but we as retail workers have absolutely no right to enforce it and therefore cannot make you. And that's how it is. In the worst case, you get slightly uncomfortable breathing. In the best case, they save lives. I know. I know that. You know that. But unfortunately, not everybody else sees that. Yeah, it's pretty, pretty shit. And I thought the US was litigious. That's the one. Big up Nikki Sturge, apparently. Anyway, games. Let's go back. Bring it back down to gaming level. Anyway, so engine art. We're not going to bother with any of those. We could put some flying tigers on. I tend not to... I think I'll be right. We may come back to them. Whoop. Let's have a look here. It's so strange how things change depending on where you are. In my hometown, everyone is pretty good at wearing masks. 10 miles away, barely anyone wears one. And they've just gone back into lockdown. That's it. They look more like sharks, don't they? They're not tigers. But I like the cube waffle. That's it. Let's drop some firecrackers. I've been watching a bike race today, and it's been awful for people not wearing masks and not social distancing. It's true, Cool Fires. It's scary, is what it is. It's scary, in a word. Right then, so let's have a look at what everybody's got on board here. We've got a couple of gloves, we've got thermal mittens and the like for the moment. Not really much else that I can equip with people here. I think I'm happy with people's crew gear for the moment. What I probably want to do is keep saving up to upgrade guns and various aspects of the aircraft. Was that our second mission? I genuinely can't remember. Did I cube waffle for so long? How many missions have I done, chat? 2? I think I actually just flapped my gums for like hours on end. Second mission. So right, we're doing our third now. Let's get the inflatable dinghy while I remember to put it in there. That's nice. We could also upgrade our electrical systems while I have the cash there. And then we'll take 1400 forward into the next mission just in case we want to get better machine guns. Let's go for our 1 hour cube hydrate. Let's go with that. Big drink. Oh dear, big drink. A mask don't make it harder to breathe as proven by several doctors. A lot of people obviously say, right, that obviously masks don't work. Face coverings don't work at stopping the virus. And that is true. A face covering that you bought off Etsy that's just made of grandma's old underpants, that isn't going to stop a virus. But it's not designed to stop a virus. As far as we know with coronavirus at the moment, it is transmitted in small droplets that are exuded from speaking, spray when you talk, the sputum when you cough and sneeze. That is how the virus is transmitted. Whilst the virus can absolutely and very easily slip through the cracks in a mask, the medium in which they travel in, the virus travels in sputum, can't. If you wear a face covering, the act of having a physical barrier in front of your face will arrest most of that sputum from getting through and keep it within your mask and reduce, if not completely eliminate, or definitely reduce to a good level, the amount of spray that comes away from your mouth and therefore the potential infectivity. If it turns out that the virus is airborne and it doesn't transmit through saliva at all, then yes, those face coverings would be really bad. But in the job of a physical barrier in terms of catching some of that spray, that is what they're designed to do. That's all they're designed to do. Good hand hygiene is essential. But in by stopping the transmission through sputum and spray, that is what they're designed to do. But there you go. Anyway, right, let us have a look then. So enemy damage down for the next two turns. Let us do a coastal patrol. Right. Let's have a look. Good stuff. As long as they catch some of it, exactly. As long as it catches some of it, as long as it catches most of it, that's how it needs to be. So, taking off, let's rock and roll. You're a sputum. That's a good insult, isn't it? You're a sputum. Yeah, that's it. The best insult I've ever heard in terms of just percussive, just raw hatred was someone be calling somebody a megalomaniac fuckstain. And I think fuckstain's a fantastic cuss. Right, so, oh, hello, hydraulics going. Just calling someone a fuckstain. Yeah, it's just awesome. An awesome swear. I apologise to any under 16s and any deep, devoutly Christian folk that I may have offended this evening. But yeah, just a beautiful curse. Heard a good one the other day, that's it. That's the one, Megalomaniac, that's it. Something to do, I know, right? Yeah, that's it. You will come into your own, Toby. You will have more work, particularly as we potentially train you as a medic secondary, or we'll actually bring you up onto some of the guns at the moment. I think that is where we'll leave you. We'll also get Nyx up to the roof here while I remember. Right. There we go. We've spotted some enemy ships. We're not going to do my usual cheese tactic of doing bombing runs alongside. I think I'm just going to worry about the photographs to begin with. So let us see here. We're going to grab our first photograph of this ship. If we grab that, the photograph is just going to take a moment to appear and tag, and then we can just go and grab this guy, which is great. I just use the same face shield and sleeve I use for motorcycle riding as a mask all the time. Fair enough, yeah. I mean, as a face covering, it does the job. You know what I mean? Like, as long as something is covering your face. I saw somebody, like, try and, like, test or, like, see how far he could push the system. It was in America. Go figure. But he was wearing like an airsoft mask, which is basically just a mesh grill, and nobody gave him shit because technically speaking it is a face covering. Obviously it's completely useless, but I think a lot of people are ignorant to what it is that they're actually trying to achieve by wearing these face masks. It's not just a form of government submission, you know what I mean? At best, you know, at worst they do nothing. At best, they save people. I think that was somebody said that in chat, and I think that's a very good way of just really breaking it down into its most basic. There we go. Thank you very much for the bit there, Walrus. Very, very kind. I don't mind. I'm an advocate for wearing masks. Straight up. It's better than nothing. That's the one. And I'm glad that most of us, most of the world, is sensible to see that. I'd like to think, or at least it is how I rationalise it in my head, the reason why we see so many people outside not wearing face masks at the moment is because all the sensible people are at home socially isolating. Let's get your man down here. There's a lot of gunfire coming out of this aircraft at the moment. It's a busy day here. That's the one. Lovely. Especially now when the second wave is kicking in, yes. Yeah, especially as the second wave is kicking in. Here in the NHS, here in Britain with the NHS, interesting fact, my old man, my dad, does national... you can exactly dox him, but... my old man works for the NHS at a national level, and he very topically moved jobs in from eye care specifically. He was what was called the National Ophthalmic Lead, which is drawing legislation for at a national level for all optometry practices, something that they all have to cover across the country. And he's recently moved into vaccinisation and immunitisation. I know, very topical, but that's just what his job role is now. As in terms of a national legislation board. Here in the UK, the National Health Service, right, is in a particular, you know, bit of trouble here in the UK. People in the UK may remember that last year and the year before, we have had, at winter time, we've had some of the worst flu seasons we have ever had. Rewind the clock before COVID, there were already people lying in corridors. You know what I mean? Like, lying in hospital corridors without a bed. The NHS was already at breaking point before coronavirus. It's the summer now, so obviously the flu season isn't that bad. But if we have another really bad flu season on top of coronavirus, it's not... unfortunately, the health service here in the UK just isn't going to cope. And it's going to be bad. Especially because we are due to have a second wave come autumn. It's not through any... But a couple of things are going to be happening. First things first is that people have been social distancing for a while. The lack of commitment to prolonged social distancing and best practice when it comes to hygiene and stuff, unfortunately, it's wearing thin with a lot of people. People are getting bored of lockdown. My aunt is a senior nurse and she's already stressing out flu season. I know, right? It's bad. A large part of which is Starve the Beast Tory policy. Austria's a totally different ballgame. That is political. We're going to try and stay on the coronavirus line. The NHS, like I say, it's already come off a really bad flu season. The virus is more likely to spread in winter. Viruses, as we know, fucking us as humans to a degree, we don't like UV light. Anything living really doesn't like UV light. It's nasty light. It's powerful light. It kills things light. And basically, you know, with the days drawing in as we go into winter and autumn, as the days get shorter, there will be less UV light. It will generally be more cloudy and gloomy and things like that, as is nature of autumn beginning. That means coronavirus is going to be living a little bit longer on surfaces that are directed to sunlight. So things like park benches, handrails and things like that out in public. The virus can survive a little bit longer on those due to the lack of UV light. So that's one thing that's going to ever so slightly contribute to transmission. The other thing is obviously temperature. The colder, not necessarily freezing cold, there is a sweet spot. But when it's in the baking sun, viruses and even many forms of bacteria tend not to multiply quite as well in those circumstances. But as it gets a little bit colder, not the freezing cold of winter, but definitely the transition between the two, that is autumn, we will find that the virus is probably a little bit more comfortable with the slightly cooler climates that will allow it to multiply more easily. So we've got a noxious brew here, at least in the UK. We've got people who are getting bored of socially distancing. People want to go back to the cinema. They want to be able to just spontaneously go to a restaurant and eat a three-course meal. People are getting bored of lockdown. We're probably due for another really bad flu season if the track record of flu seasons that we've had is anything to go by. The virus is going to be living longer on surfaces due to the lack of sunlight, and the colder temperatures are going to make the virus spread a little bit more easily. All of this, and schools opening, which is another kettle of fish, all of this is going to be sort of bundling up into actually quite a worrying 4 to 5 months here in the UK, potentially 6 months. There is going to be a second spike in the United Kingdom at some point. I mean, even countries that have been best practice, I mean, Germany's initial outbreak wasn't too bad, and even it is having a second outbreak. I think even South Korea, one of the models of coronavirus containment and tracking and tracing, even it had a second outbreak. it really is only a matter of time for a lot of countries when the second outbreak gets there. Everybody's been very pro-Hansan, very pro-mask, pro, you know, in suppressing the virus. They've done a very good job, but it's not gone. Coronavirus is still in all of the countries that it was in originally, in the background. And it's still there. And it's only going to be suppressed for as long as that we choose to suppress it. And as we reopen society and shops and all of these different things, it is going to creep back into the forte as we reintroduce the areas in which the virus was spreading and breeding. Social gatherings and all these other things. Unfortunately, until we find a way to mediate how the virus is spread much more effectively and we understand it more about how it spreads and things and measures we can take to try and slow down the spread. Once we reopen cinemas and all of these different forms, I mean, pubs has been another big... I read endlessly in the news about more pubs closing due to coronavirus transmission. It's, yeah, it's pretty scary. So, yeah, it's... We're in for a nasty ride. And the thing that's going to make it worse the second time around is that the economy... There's no room in the economy for a second lockdown. There's no appetite from the public for a second lockdown. Yeah, it's fucking... Even Pornhub is advertising hand sanitizer, yeah. Russia will not have a second wave, Mr. Putin says so. Yeah, that's the one. Russia Today says they don't have a second wave, so it must be true. Yeah, spoons almost got shut down, that's it. It's best to incorporate hand hygiene into a daily life thing, into daily life instead of a one-off thing. That's absolutely true, screwed. And we may... It's really an eye-opener for a lot of people that, you know, hand hygiene is extremely important. A story from a co-worker today... Sorry, Cube Waffle, we will get back into the game. We are getting there. A story from a co-worker today, which kind of just puts into the forte hand hygiene. Obviously, at work, we're wearing nitrile gloves, like a latex, you know, medical glove, because we obviously work with the public and we've got to keep them safe, keep us safe. So we've got, you know, single-use disposable rubber gloves. They were doing the banking at the end of the day, which is, i.e., you take all of the money from the store's tills that you've made and you count it up and you get a final figure as to how many profits or whatever you've earned that day, how much money went into the tills, how much has come out, and your net earnings for the day. In by counting the money, right, it's not like they were fucking scratching their asses with them. A fresh pair of nitrile gloves, they counted the money. Like, their fingertips were like black afterwards, right, on the nitrile gloves because of how much dirt... was actually on the money. It's not like people were dragging it through fucking sewer drains or anything like that. It's just money, you know, is handled by a lot of people and it can pick up quite a bit of dirt. And having these white nitrile gloves on kind of highlighted actually just how much dirt is on these monies. Their fingertips were like browned. Coins are really bad as well. Why are we still using cash? It's a fair question, to be fair. A lot of people are doing contactless now, which is good. My company bought 200 litres of disinfectant and they are still in storage because no one uses them anymore. Scary. Money is the dirtiest thing in the world because it moves from people to people. That's it. Money is bad stuff. The division is covered in that very well. Yeah, or division has covered that. Even words are difficult, as we know. I think I've gone on too long about coronavirus. Let's go back into... I'll probably pick it up again in a few minutes here, as somebody makes a point. But generally speaking, yes. You know. It's a good thing to... Obviously, it's an amazing thing to hand san. Obviously, wearing a mask is very important. But, I don't know. People are just kind of losing the will to partake in lockdown. People are getting bored, but the virus isn't. It's a worrying thing. Anyway, let's jump on into the upgrades here. Hello, Sweet Banana. Good to see you. How's about some game content? We're going on it. Right, let's have a look. Aircraft, then. So, we've got various upgrades there. I did actually sort of glance over the upgrades. In terms of systems, we've got better hydraulics here. We've also got better fuel tanks, oxygen tanks, and various other bits of equipment. We haven't had problems with fires just yet, so I might just equip a Mark 1 fire extinguisher just so I have some form of firefighting. But it wouldn't be anything too outrageous. Let's also try and upgrade the hydraulic system here with what's left of our money as well. Sort of give our sauerkraut even less to do by increasing the efficiency of them. But it also means things that, like, bomb bay doors and landing gears deploy a little bit faster, so it does have its uses. Nose art, we've also got the custom roundels, which we're not too bothered about there. We're just going to go through and just remove all of the little dots there. We also can upgrade to armored fuselage Mark 1, which is a treat. And we can go to the nose art and add an extra bomb on board here. Lovely stuff. Where do you work? Sounds a lot like McDonald's at the minute. I work in an optician at the moment. Well, I have done for the last 6 years I've been at Specsavers. Jesus Christ, feeling old. Like, Jesus, 6 years I've been at Specsavers. It only feels like I've been there for four. Like, it's catching up with me. Right then, so we have a mission here, defend allied transport shipping. Short duration mission with an enemy ace in the area. This is going to be nasty because we're probably not going to be able to shoot this guy down in a single go, but we do at least have enemy damage down to try and reduce the amount of damage he does to us. We probably won't get the kill, but we might at least be able to scare him off. So an allied transport ship has come under attack from enemy torpedo boats. Defend the ship at all costs. Let's begin the mission with enemy damage down, and let's rock and roll here. Should have gone to Specsavers. Goddamn, love those adverts. Somebody has to. If I could put a PSA out for Specsavers staff everywhere, I would say, just don't make this should have gone to Specsavers joke. We've done that. It's a well-trodden punchline. Yeah, we've heard it before. Oh, God, I despair. The laugh you will receive from the retail worker is not genuine tummy rumble, but a retail laugh, as I call it. The retail chuckle. Oh, God, do me a favor. Right, so I'm going to have a swig of water. Drown my sorrows. Advert told me to go to Specsavers. My town doesn't even have a Specsavers. That's it. Lovely. Specsavers are called Louis Nielsen. Is it Nielsen here in Specsavers? Was that Norway? Denmark? I don't even know. Some Scandinavia. Spicy Norway or whatever it was. There we go. Another sweep coming in here from the radar. Looks like we've got two schools of fighters engaging us here. Where are they? Very high, just coming through that cloud layer there on the right. Tag, tag, tag. Let's get Bryce over here, Toby on the front right. Let's get all these guns to work. Focus fire there, Kilo. I don't have Nyx on the right gun here, which means we did not have the right amount of protection. A little bit of damage for everyone on board, but Nyx now is at least on the right gun. It looks like all of our waste gunners have done a pretty good job in peeling those guys off of us. Very nice. Targets at ground level or at sea level here. We'll just quickly flag a reconnaissance thing there, just in case there's anything else around. We've got some recon coming out as well. Judge is slotting in behind. We have a heavy fighter that I need to tag here. Let's get him bada-binged. Let's get Mr. Kylo down onto the lower gun here, just ready for our guy to slot in underneath. Let's see how we do. Guess how many of the should have gone to Specsavers jokes, how many of them do I get a week? Probably not that many, to be honest, in the grand scheme of things. Probably only a few. Maybe one a week, twice a week, but that's enough. That's enough to destroy the soul. There we go. Destroy attacking torpedo boats. Let's leave Toby on one of the guns then, and let's pull Bryest over here to the gun position. Open the bomb bay doors. Your man is going in for the torpedo attack here. I don't think we're going to be able to nab him with this. Ooh, very juicy. That guy's tagged underneath. We need to, like, just change where it is we're flying here. Let's go back for this boat. I'm absolutely spraying the shite out of that. Mr. Kylo, drop down for me. There we go. Excellent. Come on, get that gun working. There's another torpedo boat over there. He is going to land a torpedo. Not much I can do. It's a little bit slow to turn around. I just need the chaos of this engagement to just chill out a little bit. I just need some fire discipline. That would be ace, if I could. Anyone wants to aim? I'll take literally anyone aiming for £5. Well aimed. Oh, juicy. Absolutely delicious. Right. Round over here on the left, we've got the big brooding bandito around here somewhere. Let's see if we can tag him. There he is. He's coming in high there. A little shitty biplane, but it's enough to cause us some damage if we're not careful. Mr. Frederick Falk, in he comes. Probably not going to really do any damage to him. Let's see if we can send out a bomb drop here and send it. Excellent kill. Close all the bomb bay doors. We're going to swing back around over here to defend our aircraft. Where is the bad guys? We know where one of them is. We I just need to find the rest of them. There they are, coming in. Very heavy fighters. Coming in on all sides. Let's see what we can do here. Mr. Demand, get over there. Toby, do what you can for us. Focus fire. Judge, can you focus fire for me? Quickly as you can. They're going for that engine. Come on, Judge, do what you can. Let's try and get back to the airbase if we can. Absolute blaze of glory. It's just not quite good enough. Kilo, can you get over here for me on this side? Focus fire for me, please, mate. Peel a little damage off on them. Let's swing it around. That Fokker Wolf 190 has given us some real shit there. Currently no critical hits, which is fantastic. Next focus fire. McGarrow's there to trot off there for the 2 months. Very, very kind, sir. There he is. We're not really doing any damage with these machine guns, but there's not really much I can do about it for the moment. I'll just try and keep the fire discipline going as best as I can. Absolute blistering amount of fire, but unfortunately just not quite the stopping power. There we go, we can finally get all guns focused firing on this last guy here as he pulls in. I don't think we'll be able to kill him necessarily, but well, stranger things have happened. I wonder if we can... Come on, chaps, you got it. I have faith. Toby can't turn the gun around any more than that. Variest over here for me. Yeah, we just do not have the stopping power to kill this guy, unfortunately. Just the guns aren't quite big enough. Not enough stopping power, not enough damage per bullet. And not really any accuracy, to be honest. He keeps coming in just as we're reloading. The man is really struggling there. We're going to try and get back to the airbase as quickly as possible. You guys, you, my friends, are a few... Yeah, I'm flying. There it is. Sort of running out of health here. Thank God his machine guns aren't too bad. Don't forget the recon objective. I'm actually just going to move on. I don't want to do a recon objective while being harassed by an enemy ace. Yeah, you can see here that even though a few bullets are connecting here and there, it's just not enough to do anything meaningful to the enemy. We're going to pull into the airbase here. That should push him off of us. And then we'll go down to land. Yeah, until we get better machine guns, we are very much at the mercy of him. Should break off of us here in a moment. Let us touch down to land. There we go, he's breaking away. Excellent. Said really nice, thank you very much. Lovely. Have you heard the statistic that being a bomber crew was as deadly as doing D-Day every single flight? Yes, I can almost believe that. Lovely. Lovely, lovely, jubbly. There we go. Didn't get the enemy ace. We took about a quarter of his health off, but, you know, no trophy for that. I mean, you first started working at Specsavers. You should have seen it coming. Any deaths so far? Not yet. We had very close, very close. We nearly lost, I don't know whether it was it Conan? I can't remember. Might have been Deman or someone, and someone nearly died. Hello, fire. Welcome, my friend. Armor upgrades queue? Yes, I think that's probably in our future, although guns are going to be quite important. There's no point having any armor on board if I can't actually shoot down the thing that is shooting me. Because the best offense, or the best defense, is a good offense. If the thing that is shooting at me is no longer shooting at me because it is dead, then I don't need to worry about the armor quite as much. So let us try and prioritize actually shooting. Oh, there he is. He's got fucking... Yep, Mr. Toby's schoolboy pumps. Let's get them on him. He'll be... Oh, he's got absolute fashion statement, he is. Let's have a look. He's got his fingerless gloves now. Let's get him his Glimsoles as well. Absolutely gorgeous. 141 speed. Usain Bolt wore fingerless gloves. Just saying, here he is. Right, the basic engineer set, we don't... So angry, we don't need to worry about that. Training, not really bothered about that either. I want people to work on their major qualifications first, which is excellent. The livery here, we've got the nose art stuff, digital curve. As much as I would like a massive advertisement attached to the front of my plane, sadly I do not get any royalties, so big sad on that one, we're not going to bother. Tail art... G&K, Roundel, not too bad. That's like, isn't that one the really old US AAF Roundel? Isn't that like the old, old one? Like this one, hang on, where is it? That one's like the more modern one. That one's like mid-tier, but this one's like the old one. Like, this is the old Roundel. Is that a joke? Sorry, is that for the joke I just did? Why do you hate me so much? I don't know. Don't know, Toby. Can't confirm or deny. Lovely. Right. got to be World War One or something. The red dot was the one used at the start of World War Two, but was changed partway through. Yeah, I know they did. They did swap. They changed the T-shirt halfway through. I can't remember the exact details. My brain is full of knowledge that was like sort of vaguely topical and correct, but really has no substance in terms of accuracy. Just a vague memory. The Russians were there. It was lovely. You know, to avoid a clash with the rising sun round. Ah, there you go. By midway, they'd painted the red dot. I see. Or easier PID. Very good. I mean, it's not PID or just, you know, identification. Right. Getting rid of the balls on the plane. Since the days of Borderlands 2, this has been going on, but no more. I shall triumph over you with my shitty jokes. It's fair enough. Can't argue with that, to be fair. Can't argue with that. Right then, let's see. So, in terms of gun turrets and stuff,
a lot of these are very expensive.
The war is poor. USAF don't have any money. Need to kind of grovel with some politicians at home, try and get a bit more funding, because it's a pretty sorry state. We've got to equip various bits of armoured fuselage. In fact, I may just. We'll armour up the midsection. The main rear section, we'll probably do wings. And then, finally, yeah, let's armour up the front as well. We've just spent pretty much all of the Air Force's money on upgrading a single aircraft, but what can you do? That's how it is. Right, let's have a look at here then. So we're going back over to the airfield here for enemy damage down for the next two missions. Let us rock and roll with that one. We do actually need to put another bomb drop livery on there as well, so let's get on that while I remember. Remembering weirdly to do this quite a lot. I'm normally really bad with my bomb drop liveries, but here we are. Another one of those on board, another white one, as it's just a standard mission. If we kill an enemy ace on a mission, we actually swap this out for a red bomb. And if we do the mission critical, we swap it out for a yellow bomb, which is nice. Light travels faster than sound, that's why people seem bright until you hear them speak. Very clever, very clever. I like it. Right. Has Twitch had an update recently? Yes, they've added a reply feature, because that is exactly what everyone needed. But there you go. You know, it's a novelty, and we shall learn to use it at some point. Apparently just tagging people wasn't good enough. Hello, Poyik. Good to see you, mate. Right, let us take off here, locking in the padlock here and taking off from there. It's even harder to keep track now, I know, right? And then, yeah, let us take off on the left-hand side here on our 11 o'clock vector. Get the pilot to raise the landing gear here with his fancy, with Toby's fancy Mark II hydraulics, our sauerkraut. What war hero do you think deserves a movie next? I don't know any war heroes. I don't know anything about war heroes. Vittman. Can we get one with Michael Vittman in? That's the only one that I can think of. Me, of course, that's it. WashTech. We'll get a hero movie about WashTech. Now it takes two steps to highlight and copy something from chat. It's the worst, I swear, yeah. Rommel deserves a movie, that's true. That's true. Erwan. Erwan Rommel. Erwin. Erwan. Lovely. Oh, God, I haven't done the thing with the top gunner. Nix, get up there. Sprint like you mean it. Focus fire. Focus fire. Cut them down. Oh, better late than never. Good job. Not bad, actually. A decent bit of fire coming out of there. I'm happy with that. Bring us to our 2 o'clock, please, pilot. I think Alvin York deserves a new movie. Was one made of him in the 50s. Is that right? Erwin, my mistake. It's all good. It's all good. All is forgiven. It's pronounced Wojtek, is it? Oh, there you go. Future. Right, I think, chat can't chase me. Like, chat can't chase me for pronunciation, man. They know what they're signing up for when they come here. Badly read usernames. It's a staple. It's a community staple at this point. Should I hydrate? I'm actually out of water for the moment, Truck. But I must get water. Otherwise, Truck will never forgive me. I apologize, chat. I apologize. I must go and get water. I must hydrate. I'll be back in a moment. Oh! Oh! My legs! Oh, lovely. Right, back in a sec. Oh, Bish, I've been called a Bish. Right. Oh, lovely. Right, had my drink. In fact, I'm going to cube hydrate again, just so Car can hear me. Oh God, she's off again. What? What is it?
Rice on the floor.
There's rice on the floor. I apologize. She's going again, chat. She's going again. Get me a Rottweiler. I think I dropped a single grain of rice on the ground. That is it. Murder, death, or death. The dunking chair for me, I think. Right, let me just have a drink. Our man Car here. He is most definitely not a 18-wheeler. Ugh. Lovely. Could also be a van, not a car. Who knows? Big angry sad evening. Hi there, Jane. Welcome. Mine from Boynan. That kiss tasted of belch. That was very disgusting. Big love. The pasty. Halls Suva. Have a Halls Suva, did you? Thank you for sharing. Now I can place that taste. Breath stank.
As if you don't have ass stank.
Yeah, to be fair. Oh, man, I had the shits this morning. Sorry, probably too much information, but yeah, there it is. I'm telling you. Getting old, chat. Incontinence is creeping in at the ripe old age of 22. It's terrible. She's laughing in the kitchen. Disgusting. No, I need more information. Fair enough. I'll let you know. Good stuff. You're 22? Yes? Better believe it, sister. I'm 22. Loads of cube waffle. Good to hear you're hydrated. Thank you very much, matey. I'm happy to be hydrated, in so many words. Yongan. Bloody hell. I know, right? Big shock. Oh, I've been called a bish, and she's out. She is yeeted. Lovely. Let's get Kylo down low here, as we're probably not going to get attacked on our right-hand vector. Riced here, front and center. Open bomb bay doors, ready two bomb drops. Whoa. We're going to be able to get a ground target here, or a ground reconnaissance. Lovely. Tag that guy just so he is on people's radar. Very, very good. Just flying through in a blaze of glory here. People doing a very good job of actually doing some damage there. The armor plate's actually taking a lot of the run there, which is perfect. Let's just quickly get Toby over here to this like front right gun. And then let's quickly just grab this reconnaissance photograph as we come over here. Now approaching the Ba Sing Se, I don't know. So yeah, that's it. We'll go around here. Lovely. Good night from Denmark. See you later, Alan. Have a lovely evening. Yeah, you too, mate. Have a good night. Round the back. Where did they go? Where are those fucker walls? Where is it? Come on, Judge. You got it. That's the stuff. Anybody dead? Judge is a little bit damaged as a result of his attack there, but it's not too bad. Lovely, got the reconnaissance, there we go. The maid of all work in the Luftwaffe. That's the one. Lovely. You are now very silent. If the gun's shooting, which they do a lot, we can barely hear you. Is that better? Sorry, I wasn't necessarily talking stringently into the microphone there. The actual sphere of audio, I'm technician, don't you know? The actual, like, sort of area around the microphone that it picks up is, like, pretty good. Incoming? What do you mean, incoming? Oh, hello. There's another one. Listen to my voice. Listen. Right. Where are they? There they go. There's one over there. Oh, and over there. ASMR Bomber Crew stream. That's it. Down low, Kylo. It's a big rhyme. That's it. Fuck it. Look, there's priorities here, Kylo. That is not one of them. Hello? Oh, is he not tagged? Is that why? Am I being a bamboozle? Am I? Yeah, he's not tagged. That's why. That's why everything is going wrong. This is why all things in life have turned sour. Sour cone. There it is. ASMR podcaster. I'm getting Rising Storm flapbacks. Lovely. Do you not have auto tag yet? No, this is very early on in the campaign. Poor Judge is getting turned into Swiss cheese there. There you go. Okay, Judge, quickly, you come over here for us, mate. Toby, run down and just sit on the rear gun. Okay, mid-fuselage isn't actually doing too bad. I made the right choice, upper-arming the fuselage there. Yeah, boy. Yeah, you're right. Lovely. The relaxing sounds, Trumpets of Jericho ASMR. That's... Oh dear. Christ, but I'm having a drink. Stiff liquor, please. Q, is the Twitch thought of ASMR confirmed? Probably. I'm going to be the reason we all die, aren't I? Maybe, Kylo. Maybe. Maybe. It's alright. It's alright. I didn't tell you to shoot it. I suppose you're following orders. He's building an immunity to bullets. That he is, to be fair. He's very immune. Right then, pulling in for the landing here. Excellente. Down we go. Over the landing gear. Big boys start simping. Why are you shooting? That's the one. He's following orders. He's a good soldier.
Can I shoot him now, boss? There were all kinds of rain.
Jesus. Right. Okay, touching down.
I must admit, I'll get a little bit tired.
Oh, God. Screed's been shot. There it is. Oh, no, he hasn't. He's been self-shot. He's committed Japan suicide, apparently. Good call on the armor upgrades. It really was. Lovely. Let's have a look. Right then. So, we got $1,200 for destroying the airfield. Another $800 for return to base. $80 for slow time. And $1,000. Or reconnaissance photograph. He screwed himself. That he did. What Wojtek is it? Is it Wojtek? I can't remember. Tech. I'll just call you underscore now. can't remember. Can you change it to something that I can pronounce? Can you change your name to Bill? Please. They really nerfed Intel in this DLC. They really did. Yeah, to be fair. Takes a long time to gather stuff. But hopefully we'll creep into level 6 with this. Halfway, actually, not that bad at all. Defensive fire on a lot of the gunners. Finally, auto tag unlocked and lean fuel plus, which is nice. He committed Sudoku. That's the one. The yawn that ends them all. That's the one. I'm just. Okay, I've done it. Also, what's with these SpongeBob teeth? Look at those. I fucking kill someone with that. Yeah, you open a fucking. You can open like a non-pull ring can with that. Christ above. You can lift up like manhole covers. God. Brutal. Brutal weapons. Gotta file those down if you want to travel on a plane, mate. Right, auto tag is German for car day. It is car day. He can scrap cable gutters in strap or scrape cable gutters. That's it. He can till the earth. Biological can opener. That's the one. Super Schlong is my stripper name. If you can't pronounce Wojtek, Super Schlong. I shall try and remember Super Schlong. Lovely. Right, okay, lightweight fuse. It's throwing me off a bit. Throwing me a curveball, it has. So, lightweight fuse, large Mark 1, aluminium red trim, armoured engine Mark 1, homing pigeon Mark 1, and radar Mark 2. Absolutely magnificent. Excellent. I say, do you know the story of Super Schlong the Bear? It's not something the Jedi, the park rangers would tell you. Jesus. Right, okay. Aircraft then. Let's put another... bomb drop on there. Let's see then. The livery here. Nose art. Customize. Let's see. Another one of those. Another Borg standard white bomb mission here. Absolutely brilliant there. Take a look at engines. Armored engine Mark 1. Systems radar Mark 2. Fuselage dunk dunk. So I probably don't want to go with light. The problem is, right, is that fucking... I don't know who is designing the lightweight armoured fuselage, right? Or the lightweight fuselage, right? But the fucking radio operator sits here, and it's just like... I don't know whether, like, you just you had an argument one day, or you slept with his wife, the guy that designs the armor plate. But look at this. They fucking, the only bit that they down armor is the bit right over the fucking gunner, for God's sake. Like, literally all of this. You can have any of that, but no. The bit right over the guy being protected is fucking naked. It's just shocking. So we're not going to bother with any of that. We're going to save our money and pay it forward. We're going to go for a Mark 1 homing pigeon, and then we're going to pay and save forward if we can. Livery, base paint, I'm not too bothered about me aluminium trim. I've got to be honest, I like my default for the moment. Let's have a look. Well, no, training's fine, so we're going to go and do the briefing. Let's have a look. Is your name in reference to the bear from World War II? I have no idea. Oh, no, you're talking to a old stripper over there. An old stripper's not a name you want. Witch's tits. Lovely. Christ above. I need like a podcast where I just get drunk. Like, honestly, I'm not even drunk and I talk fucking nonsense. Honestly, I do. Like, I'm terrible with drinking me. Like, it's this, but turned up to 8,000. I just talk absolute drivel. I could talk a dog off a meat truck. It's just awful. I'd pay for the podcast, sir. Thank you. Q podcast would be fantastic. That's it. Yes. His name didn't have a C, though. That's the one. Drunk stream next Friday. Twitch pub sesh. That's it. How was your drinking, sir? You could do one with Chinny, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, we could fucking flap our guns. I could flap my guns with Chinny. That's the one. Q for Prime Minister when? I don't know about that. Fucking, did someone... Oh, God, See, right, that's it. I was racially profiled once. Here we go. Right, fucking... A customer thought at work that I was related to David Cameron. Excuse me. You know, fucking literally. Like, that was just... I've never been so offended in my entire life. Anyway, let's do a coastal patrol. Right, you, Digby, and Chinny would be a wild time at the Derailed Podcast. That's it. Call it a podcast. Write that down. I don't know who I'm talking. Write that down. Jane. Hang on. Discord. Jane. Write that down. I've wrote wire that down. I hope she understands. A podcast, that's pretty good as well. Surely someone else on Twitch has had that. Surely someone else had podcast. That's pretty good. Podcast is fantastic, coin of phrase. Well done. Someone hit the patents office. Can you patent like a coin of phrase or the name of a show, or would that just be copyright? I'm sure that's just copyright. You can't like patent that, can you? That would just be intellectual property. Hugh, are you sure you're not drunk? I'm high on life, apparently. Would that be a trademark? Right. Okay, good. It's a good thing. I'm getting a crash course in trademarks from my fucking Twitch viewers 6 years into the service. what is a music license? Can I get one on eBay? for Tree Fiddy, can I get one? It's the Copyright Designs and Patents Act. Right. Soon TM, that's it. So a lot of people say that they don't necessarily understand like copyright when it comes to like music licensing and things. It's actually incredibly simple. I did a shitload of homework as to what is, you know, considered acceptable, right? And basically the gist of it is if you're making money and you don't use a license, or if you don't have the license for the music that you're using, then that's a big bad. And that's it. That's as complicated as it needs to be. If you are using music in a medium in which you are generating profit, then that is a big bad.
What does a deaf gynecologist do?
Oh my God.
He reads lips.
Blade, come on now. Oh, God. You're a Christ of it. Did you just dream that up? Lovely. Terrible. Disgusting. That's it. I'm sorry, I had very little sleep. I'm at that level of jokes. It's alright. It's a cheap laugh. Congrats, Blade. You've made me laugh. There you go. I will use Google Translate. Don't do it. Don't do it, friend. Right, let us take another fair tear of this guy, and then we should be good to go here. Not very exciting missions, unfortunately, at the start of the campaign, but there is a certain amount of grinding that we need to do before we go any further on than this. We do have to engage some hostile patrols. We've got 1, 2, 3 closing in the right. I've just realised once again, in my cube waffling state, that Mr. Nix here is not in the right place. Bryce over there, you over here. Kylo, can you focus fire for us? Probably not. They're not in your arc of fire for whatever reason. Looks like we've got, what is that, a couple of What's It fighters closing in from over there. Well, there they are. Tag, tag, tag. Managed to find them. Let us swing back around towards home base here. Another fucking fighter coming in from somewhere. There's one. A little bit of damage to the tail of the plane there. Nothing we can't handle. Judge, focus fire. Nix, I'll have you focus fire upon reloading. Toby can't focus fire, but at least the gun is working. We've got a guy dropping down low. Oh my god, Jesus, that's a big explosion. Can't you also bomb the ships? Yes, you can. But I'm being lazy and not doing that. Lovely. Copyright laws are horrendous. They secure interests of distributors, not authors. That's it. Yeah, that's the worst, isn't it? They don't even protect the interests of the people who actually own the content, but the distributors, the people who distribute it. Yeah. So not the musician, but the music license holder, or like the record company, if you want to say. What's the purple glow? It's just like a particle effect to show that a special ability is being used.
It's a change of building.
£5 from Umbra there. Oh, God.
A skeleton
one.
Walks into a bar and asks for a beer and a mop.
Jesus Christ. I don't have any new jokes, to be fair. I don't have anything new. So you've heard them all before, chat. I can't come up with fresh dad joke material every stream. It's impossible. I'm not a dad. I don't have those genes, I'm afraid. Taylor Swift got screwed by her record company. Really? I don't know. I don't really listen to any good music, unfortunately. I've got, well, I suppose it depends what your definition of good music is, but my fucking music library is a horrendous mashup of Weird Al Yankovic, Creedence Clearwater Revival, and I don't know. And some other stuff. I can't even think of anything that springs to mind. CCR is great. Yeah, to be fair, they are. Dank gamer music. Tell me about it. That Minecraft C418 music, man. That's where it's at. Jamming. Today my son asked, can I have a bookmark? I burst into tears. 11 years old and he still doesn't know my name. It's old. It's old news, Cowface. We've heard it all before. Hello, Dark Reaver. Good to see you, mate. She doesn't own the rights to any of her first 7-something albums. In fact, the record company sold the rights to some guy who has been creepy. Oh my god, really? That's horrible. Yeah, to be honest, I've just, like, what's been quite lucky about me is that, like, I tend not to use, like, pretty mainstream music. I like to think that I make my own content when I play these games. I flap my gums and I talk about random rubbish. And that's part of the reason why I've not been too badly affected with the whole dit. Like, because I know that a lot of people, even a couple of people in fucking, in ZF, like, had to completely bin their, like, VOD libraries. And purge all of their clips to try and get away from the whole big DCMA strike or DMCA. I keep saying DCMA, I don't know why. It's my copyright version, it's my copyright drugs, it's my copyright MDMA. It's just awful. YMCA, that's it. The purge, yeah, it's really weird. Like, it's just, I suppose it's fair enough, right? Because Twitch can't come... So for ages, like, Twitch has always been a bit of an advocate. It's like, oh, yes, we do enough to make sure that, you know, stuff like this doesn't happen on our platform, that, you know, we're keeping on top of music licensing. And for the longest time, redlining, where you'd go and watch...
Change, you filthy animal.
$4.99. There it is. The top model's daughter became one. It's in... Sorry? The top model's daughter became one. It's in the genes. If you could listen closely, you can hear the gears grinding in my brain. It's too tired. I'm too tired. until I cannot brain. Purge the heretics, that's it. There's a purge that went on during last month or so, not only on Twitch, but a lot of YouTube stuff as well. Wasn't Warner Brothers the big one? Weren't Warner Brothers like the ones? Not Warner Brothers. Time Warner was it? Something Warner. My housemate said I better not use his kitchen utensils again or there'd be trouble. I told him that's a risk I'm willing to take. That's a good one. I've not heard that one before. Jeans equals jeans. I know, but like my tiny brain has like... The top model's daughter. What top model? I'm confused. I'm sorry. I've completely butchered this joke. You've got a lot of lols in chat, Conan, so it's clearly a good joke. But unfortunately, Hugh's tiny mind has failed. Any top model? What do you mean any top model? I need names. I need specifics. The top model, like a fashion model. You've lost me. A fashion model. The leading farmer on Tweed Monthly. Is that top model? I don't know. You've lost me, I'm afraid. Knew I recognised your name. Which name? I don't know. Nihilistic. Good to see you, mate. Fuck's sake. I missed an also. Oh, I did miss an also. I cube-readed it. You missed a word that I'm overthinking it. Can you repeat the question? The top model's daughter also became one. It's in the genes. Yeah, that's a funny joke. I like that. That's great. Oh, all right. I'll see myself out. Lovely. Car salesman, top model. That's it. Lovely. Right. Through we go. See, that would have been really funny. Nice. Right, okay. Anybody level up? Nope, just barely. Everybody at level 6. Not much else to report. We'll add another bomb drop livery. Congrats, Q. Thank you. Where's the joke? I know. Right. Jokes are always funnier when you explain them. Absolutely. Live by those rules and, well, you'll get a response, all right. Okay, livery then. So we've actually been going for fucking 2 hours here, to be honest. I've actually talked for hours, literally hours here, about Big Rona, about loads of stuff. We've talked about loads of drivel over this stream, to be honest. Let's have a look. Base paint scheme, we can go and put on a nose art.
Keep the change. Oh,
Jesus, £5 from Blade again. Oh, God.
What does a tired man knit with? Yawn.
Oh, God. Right. Okay. Draw that. Lovely. Get out, lol. That's the one. Oh, dearie gosh. Yeah, fucking... It's just one of them, isn't it? Fucking Freudian slips, they happen to the best of us. Jesus. Jesus H. I almost thought that joke broke you, Q. No, it's all right. I'm still there. I have me faculties. Most of them, I think. People told me Beethoven couldn't continue with his career, but did he listen? Jesus Christ. Christ. Right, no. Right. Okay, I think we're going to call that there for an evening. You also add a bomb for taking photos? No, I don't do anything like that, Sipstaff. Just basic missions, I add a bomb. If it's a mission that we kill an enemy ace, I add a red bomb. And if it's a mission critical, I add a yellow bomb, which is nice. What do you call an alligator in a vest? An investigator. Lovely, lovely. Last mission, you didn't drop a bomb. It's less to signify bombings and more to signify successful missions. I understand it is not a perfect system. Right. I missed a joke from Astronaut, did I? Was it a good joke? Did I? How far back can I go? I've got my right-hand screen here. Astronaut. Where is he on my big list? Astronaut. Then I insulted sodium and chlorine. They got salty. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. That's the one. Fantastic. That's it. Right. Change color for intel missions. What do you mean, change color for intel missions? No, I wouldn't change them for that. I think that's chill for now. Right. I'm going to leave it there before the dad jokes just spew into Twitch as a wider hole and I'm fucking executed for being patient zero with regards to the dad jokening of 2020. So yeah, I'm going to bugger off for the evening. So thank you everybody for tuning in today. Yeah, hopefully we all had a good time. Horses don't go to the vet when they are sick. They go to the hospital. To that joke, I say nay. Lovely. Last one. I don't think I understand the gravity of the situation. Don't worry, it will hit you soon enough. That's it. Lovely. Brilliant. Hi, offended, I'm Toaster. That's it. Night, Skipper. Yeah, I'm going to bugger off for the evening. Let's see who else is online. So if I just quit out of that, I want to save it, don't I? And then let us go to the main menu. Game's all saved up, which is magnifique. Lovely, lovely. Good night, Q in chat. Yep, good night, everyone. Let's see who else is online. I imagine a lot of us are going to be going to bed, but for the people that are up, the Yanks amongst us, or the people with awful sleep schedules, I'll probably be going as well, to be honest, because I've just barely managed to claw my sleep schedule back to normalcy, so I'm not so willingly willing, I guess that makes sense, to throw it away. So let's see who's on. Miss Teebs, I think Teebo is going to be a lovely individual for us to go and raid. She's chilling out with some marbles on stream at the moment. Let's go and freak her out a little bit. Lovely. Right, so this is Teebo, a friend of mine. Yeah, feel free to say hi, send her my best, and I will catch you all on the flip side. She'll kind of like freak out a little bit, so be gentle. So yeah, thanks everybody. Have a lovely evening. And I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Great to see you. Fucking hell, Quebec. Gina, how much did...